going to be a factor. The goalies play out of the goal, especially in the clearing game. And I think Coach Yamati feels that Vigu gives them a little bit more play there.
Matthew Noon starts, outstanding freshman for Virginia, coming off an ACC Defensive Player of the Week honor. As we get underway here this afternoon, a scramble for possession. Off of that first draw, the Cavaliers will retain possession to get things started here this afternoon. Watch Virginia offensively, of course, Schellenberger up top. They will set.
And again, the first indication of Schellenberger's fundamentals, the quality of his passing, just remarkable. Really, he's a young man who, frankly, I'm old school, but he dazzles me with the consistency of his play.
Schellenberger, 50 points, now 30 assists, and a quick win off the draw for Lasalla. Jake Saunders trying to gain possession, but played this Virginia squad last year. Lasalla won 19 of 27 faceoffs. And going up against the freshman Cheynoy today, he's picked up another one.
And again, I think, Dalton Young and Lansbury and Frankeny are going to get the full attention for Virginia and are likely to have their hands full. So it's really important that Dunn and some of these other guys step up for Virginia.
Virginia survives that Richmond pressure. Pass in close for a Schellenberger.
That's going to need to happen for Richmond today in order to finish this to be successful.
So we're all even at two apiece. Virginia has five shots to Richmond's three. Once again, Lasalla with the win. Won all of the faceoffs to this point, but we are tied at two.
That is way early here. So if that trend continues, that's going to be an issue for Richmond going forward.
Here at the X, a violation will give Virginia possession. He's battling. He's won 50.6% of his faceoffs. But this is one of the tougher tests he'll face. And all season long, he's had to face some top-notch draw for the inside. Second goal for Corbier this afternoon from the junior out of Ontario, 6'2", 230-pounder. And back to the draw, the shovel to Connor. Virginia holds possession.
Players, that's what makes Virginia particularly dangerous, is that Schellenberger's getting a lot of the attention, but Matt Moore is a number one attackman for anybody.
Now Richmond has gone with Nate Garlow on that draw, and the Spiders come away with possession. Garlow played some against Hampton.
My point earlier was that you just can't play slowly. You can't play a four corners offense like teams used to try to do. The shot clock forces you to play some. And Richmond is much more athletic than they used to be, more athletic than they get credit for. They come into a game like this wanting to get after Virginia a little bit. We're going to see a lot of goals scored today. He's going to be a really good player. He's a skilled kid with that size. He's just going to be a handful going forward. And they, even now, it's a great service if you can force the team to pick a pole up. And that's what he does, and it opens up the field for Xander Dixon.
Big hit on Lasalla, but a penalty coming against to Richmond after that. Lasalla trying to head for a goal after winning the faceoff. Penalty comes up against the Spiders.
Petey Lasalla, little fire plug of a player, and those face-off guys do take a beating. He had a share of injuries over the years.
Braden McClure called with a push there. And off goes Lasalla to the Virginia bench for him. Virginia's got a four-goal lead with 2:12 left here in the first. Ability to score evident today. Remember, this Richmond defense.
I don't know about that. I don't know about 11.
7-4 Virginia leads as the quarter winds down. Penalty was also assessed, so a 1 minute man up opportunity here for Richmond.
Don't pass it. Defense, that's the key piece.
Ecology was there for Richmond, but didn't slide over far enough to pick up shots at that time. With the Lasalla out, you see Gabe Braun in for Virginia at the X. Nice return. recovery there by Shane Grant so far this season for Virginia. Tough stop there for the young man.
We'd like to see Richmond settle in on defense and have a couple of good possessions where they get a couple of good stops.
Virginia able to scoop in and win that one.
Richmond really just wants to go back and forth with these guys trading goals. I think they need to settle down a little bit defensively.
We were talking before the going forward. And Cheynoy comes out with a win at the X, tries to get a shot off. Virginia's defense, good job there with the long stick. Well, they had the good defensive effort against Notre Dame last time out, obviously, but Richmond offense today having some success of its own. 13 shots, 10 of which have been on.
You just can't get it quite figured out. The other team is on a roll, and it just may be it's going to require somebody to outscore somebody else.
Interestingly enough, and now, you know, this Richmond offense in the attack, year after year, seems to always have, as Joe Gooley scoops up that ground ball, breaks into the offensive end, always has Dipson Young's shot. Didn't hit anything. It bounced right into Dunn's possession, and he was able to find Lanchbury an alert pass. Spiders came into today with 10.12 assists per game, and that was second in the country. Not set for the third quarter. In continuing with what Dan Chamati had mentioned earlier, Virginia's been an exceptional third quarter team, and they've outscored opponents 43-19 all season in the third quarter. So for the Cavaliers, they would like that to stay 43-16, actually, is the number, 2-4. And here comes Braun off the win. His shot knocked down in front.
Great save.
Scooped up by the Cavaliers, though. Danny Parker.
Opportune spot at the right moment.
Cheynoy working against Braun here. Once again, we see Parker come in for Virginia from that wing spot. A lot of contact there. Richmond comes away with play.
Richmond is just, you know. And as Virginia starts to get a little bit antsy about trying to make something happen here, those opportunities may present themselves for Richmond.
Battle here for this draw. Cheynoy comes out with it. On the run, dishes. Now Richmond resets. Got a 3-goal lead. That is their first goal since then. Now a stalemate here at the X for the moment. Cheynoy digs out another one. Got some pressure from Whalen, but
Delph. Talking to my team saying, look, there's no scoreboard, there's no clock, we just got to keep playing. You know, Richmond is carrying the play, I would say, to start the third quarter here, and they want to keep their foot on the gas.
Virginia gets possession, violation, but
they dodge. But then our players gained more confidence in throwing the ball into him and just began throwing it into him from everywhere because he caught everything. And that's the unique quality that those indoor players have. You know, so you're going to throw balls to Peyton Cormier that you might not throw to anybody else on the team because they can make those kind of plays.
Shane Grant, quick Virginia start.
No, and I think for fans in general, Richmond's reputation a little bit is a little bit more conservative, perhaps, offensively. So people might be surprised at the score or their ability to box.
Battling at the X there. Virginia comes away with it. Good play by Scott Bauer off that wing.
Tell you, Robert, it's less stressful being up here than it would be to be on that sideline right now, going into the fourth quarter here.
So back to the X we go to open quarter number four. Spiders have 34 shots. Virginia with 35. Good win there from Gabe Braun. had some time at the X this year. He had won 41% of his faceoffs coming into today. Stays on the field for a moment for the offense. Cormier with possession. Now they'll switch out. Richmond got a break on the penalty. Take advantage. Now the violation of the faceoff. Possession back to the Spiders. Of the X situation there. And if you're on the other side, Gabe Braun's going to step up for Virginia now. Or the Wings have to get involved even more.
Well, at the very least for Richmond, it's turned into a 50-50 situation, which is probably better than we imagined was going to happen. So it's a battle going back and forth there for those players. Each of these possessions on him and take the body and to stop him. Can't be reaching for his stick.
There's another big draw. The Virginia side, Richmond as well. Cheynoy comes away with it. Tried to get it back to Grant, had some pressure on him. Start.
You know, Cheynoy, I know even though Lasalla got hurt early, he's been a strong factor for Richmond in the second half. Figu, clearly, and then some of the names that we've mentioned, Nugent, Dunn, certainly the Dalton Youngs of the world, all those things had to come together for this to happen.
Virginia has a possession.